What's going on? Hope you're doing great. I got videos to look at. If I had the time, I would have knocked out Southern Fried's War Games match, Team Manders against Team Sexton, but I'm definitely going to get to that tomorrow at the latest. But this was sent to me more than I've ever received anything. Two of the members of the Left Hand Path sent it to me to look at, but so did a bunch of other people, including one person who I didn't even know, who I wasn't even friends with on Facebook until they sent me this. So a lot of people want me to look at this promo. I see that it's 6 minutes long. It looks pretty righteous. So let's just get into it. Let's see what's going on with it. Oh boy, there's the music copyright that's gonna hit me. Okay, so far so good. Like Steve, why are you stopping it? Nothing's even happened yet. On the contrary, they did something that's very important. It's important in film work, and it's important in any kind of story you're trying to tell, and a promo is a story, is it not? Establishing shots. What do we know based on this? We got three title holders here, guys. What else do we know? They're pulling up in the nice car. Way to hit the car wash first, guys. It's shining. It's shining. I used to be in the car wash business. I know of which I speak. Look at the. Okay. Does that not look great? Does this not look great? The sky here. I don't know who shot this. Whoever did the cinematography for this, whoever shot this, did a great job. You got the clouds up here. It just looks expansive. It looks bigger than life. It invokes this feeling of it being wide open. And then the reflection off of the hood. Again, they got the car clean. That's a good move, but it really, just for this shot alone, I really love this shot. I really love it. So now I'm ready to listen because they care about what they're doing. They put some thought into it. They have earned my listen. That's how I approach these kind of things, and I have a feeling I'm not alone. If this was just, dude cutting a promo in his car with his phone, I'd be less inclined to want to listen to what they're going to say. That's what I'm saying. Austin gets out, and he's friggin' a head and a half taller than Trevor. And here they are next to their titles. I see. Let's go.
Southern Violence and Wrestling. IWTV. Your inaugural show for IWTV is called Walk the Path.
Oh.
Coincidence?
So their first show for IWTV. It's called Walk the Path. Oh, now Eric Silva gonna, is he gonna be happy about that? Is he gonna be mad about that? Let's see.
Providence.
Great word.
Maybe. Or maybe we just those dudes everyone needs to see.
Oh!
This show has been billed as Southern Violence and Wrestling versus the Left Hand Path.
Oh.
Everything on the line for Southern Violence and Wrestling. So, I figure we'll match that energy. I figure we'll raise the stakes too. It's only fitting that we have something on the line too.
I've looked at a few Eric Silva promos in the past, and I've watched a few on my own that I didn't directly review, like I'm reviewing this one. This is the best that I think he has done from the jump. Where he is clearly sort of taking control of this promo, setting up Austin Tower and Trevor Aeon for success. That's what you do when you're a great promo cutter. I know a lot of people are going to try to give me shit and say, "You're saying this is great already?" I think it's great. He's putting over the promotion, he's putting over the main story that it's us against them, and he's calm. He has a kind of understated energy but he delivers everything so effectively, it invites you to lean in and listen. It's that cliche they always said about, like, Arn Anderson didn't yell and scream and blah, blah, blah. But there were a lot of guys who cut promos like that who people didn't listen to. It really is about the kind of, it's about your presence that you carry through. Hear me, wrestling people. It is, they're buying you. So, no, you don't have to yell and scream, but you have to be engaging. And I would argue that he is being engaging.
Right. So, Bobby D, you listening?
Ooh.
I want you to pay attention to this. I may not have captured gold here at Southern Violence and Wrestling, but I have captured it elsewhere. Multiple times, might I add.
Mm.
But, if you're interested, the Pro South All Out Championship. I'll do you a favor. We'll raise the stakes. I'll put this on the line.
Oh.
But I promise you. I promise you. It ain't going nowhere.
Damn that motorcycle for being
Aaron
in the
Black
background.
When I first found out you weren't going to wrestle me, I thought you were trying to clout chase.
Aaron Black. So he immediately, Trevor jumps in, says who his opponent is. It's a very different promo style. Is he looking at the camera? No. So do I dislike that? I don't. Because the energy is different than Eric's. Even though he's not looking, it's almost like it's disrespect. He's talking to Aaron Black, but he's not looking at the camera. I like it. I like it. It's impudent. And I like it. All right, let's get back to the beginning.
Aaron Black. When I first found out you weren't going to wrestle me, I thought you were trying to clout chase.
Oh!
But I ain't really got clout like that for you to be chasing. It means three things to me.
Oh my God. Okay, he caught me off guard. I thought you were clout chasing, which is something that young people say, right? But then he goes like, but I ain't really got clout to chase. I like it. It's self-deprecating. It's funny. And now he's going to get into this, but what it means, the three things. And I want to hear the three. Let's see if he brings... When you set up things to do in threes, expectation is it hits, it hits, it really hits on that last one. Let's see if he follows through with that promise.
One, you really do want to test yourself. Two, you couldn't be too happy in your life. And that leads me to three. You obviously have a death wish.
That
now,
got
don't
serious.
Get me wrong.
That got serious.
I'm deeply flattered that you want to test yourself, and that I'm the one that you want to test yourself against.
Oh.
Really, really flattered. But flattery will get you killed. And just to make sure.
All right. I'm gonna, I like this promo so much that I'm gonna do something that is really runs against my normal way of thinking about things. Some people may listen to this and go, I don't like it. It feels like it's jumping all over the place emotionally. Sometimes he just seems really happy and jovial, and then he goes right into this really serious thing, and he even did like kind of like a growly voice. And there's people who for whom they would that would turn them off, and they would think of it as a sign of it's not a good promo, or it's not professionally done, or it's inadequate. I am of the opposite mind. It is so quirky, and it is so unique that I am going to hear it through. And what I suspect is that I will just like it as a thing that maybe I don't fully understand, but it is engaging nonetheless. I'm going to cop to the fact that I'm of two minds. I am ambivalent. That's what ambivalent means. Ambivalent doesn't mean I don't care. Ambivalent means I am of two separate minds on it. But what I am in agreement on, both sides of my brain agree on, is I want to hear more, so let's hear more.
You don't back out upon hearing that? I'm going to raise the stakes, too.
I like this trope that they keep going to.
Wrestling Alliance No Limits Championship ain't never been defended at Southern Violence and Wrestling, has it? Congrats, Aaron. You get a title shot now. Charlie Anarchy.
Sure.
You sure had a lot to say now, didn't you? That's real cute, man. Charlie Fucking anarchy is what you call yourself. You must think that you have a big head. You might be stupid. Matter of fact, I think he is stupid. Because let me go ahead and correct you on some things. First of all, you ain't going to go ahead and disrespect my boys here by calling them little cronies. Oh. Because that man could whoop your ass. And trust me, that man could whoop your ass. Multiple time champions, as you have clearly seen. The
small stuff. Small stuff that Towers is doing and the guys are doing to back him up. One, they feel like a unit. They feel like a group. They don't feel like three guys that are slapped together. They're obviously guys who like each other, who have been around each other, who have worked together. But look at when he talks about Trevor, that Trevor gives us a thing. He activates. When his button gets pushed, he gives us something. Same with Eric Silva. I really like it. And again, why am I breaking it down? Because this is worth being broken down. This is a piece of art, and I am interpreting it. And I like that they've gone so hard with it. I like it.
That man could whoop your ass. And trust me, that man could whoop your ass. Multiple time champions, as you have clearly seen.
Yeah.
The stakes cannot be raised any higher.
The best Austin Towers promo I have seen him do already. I'm just putting that out there.
Southern Violence and Wrestling. Now on to more important things.
Yeah.
Charlie Anarchy. For an entire year, I have carried this company on my back.
Oh,
matter of fact, in its 6 years of existence, nobody talked about Southern Violence and Wrestling until Austin Towers, the Chief, showed up. And until I was the one who carried the mantle of being the best big man in Georgia. No,
he demands your attention with his voice, with his energy, with the confidence with which he speaks, with every movement that seems perfectly thought out and delivered. He commands your attention. That is what promos are all about. Promo, short for what? Promotion. And all these guys are promoting fights. They're promoting the next show. I know the who, what, where, when, why. But more importantly, I'm engaged. Great job.
Nobody knew that this title existed.
Ooh.
Until the Chief, Austin Towers.
That's true.
Held this belt.
That is true.
Now you want to try and make it against SVW versus the Left Hand Path. Y'all think y'all that good. Y'all think they think that they're that special.
Oh, look at the reaction from right Trevor.
Now, let me tell you something. You might have a strong hand, but I got a stronger foot. And I'm going to shove it so far up your ass that not only you're going to feel it, not only is your general manager, Justin, going to feel it, not only is Athens going to feel it, but this whole damn state is going to feel it. And I'm going to make sure I wiggle them toes deep inside to make sure that it gets real uncomfortable. Because it's going to be real uncomfortable when I take your belt and I send your ass to the hospital.
Yes!
Your ass signed the check that you just can't.
Fuck you, I'm listening to that whole bit again. I'm listening to that whole thing again. Listen to it, Bill.
Y'all think y'all that good. Y'all think they
he's here.
That they're that special. Trust me, right, man. Let me tell you something. You might have a strong hand, but I got a stronger foot.
Oh.
And I'm going to shove it so far up your ass that not only you're going to feel it, not only is your general manager, Justin, going to feel it, not only is Athens going to feel it, but this whole damn state is gonna feel it. And I'm gonna make sure I wiggle them toes deep inside to make sure that it gets real uncomfortable.
The key to great writing, whether you're writing a novel, short story, a movie, television show, a painting on the wall, anything that you can invoke beyond just one of your senses is successful. There's a secret for you, those who create. If you can invoke a sense besides the most obvious one, you are successful. Austin, he's triggering the auditory. He's triggering the visual by his look and by the look of Eric Silva and Trevor Aeon. But that, I'm going to stick my foot up your ass, is a tired cliche. But he immediately makes it something special and different that I've never heard before of, I'm going to wiggle them toes. He invokes the feeling, the sense of physical touch, in addition to sight, in addition, It's fucking great. I should not have stopped it, but I just had to point that out because it's so important. Austin, please go off, and I will please let you say the whole thing.
Let me tell you something. You might have a strong hand, but I got a stronger foot. And I'm going to shove it so far up your ass that not only you are going to feel it, not only is your general manager, Justin, going to feel it, not only is Athens going to feel it, but this whole damn state is going to feel it.
God
and I'm going to make sure I wiggle them toes deep inside to make sure that it gets real uncomfortable, because it's going to be real uncomfortable when I take your belt and I send your ass to the hospital. Your ass signed the check that you just can't cash. You're too broke to try and step up to my level.
Nice. Again, another cliche of the check that you can't cash, but then he just said you're too broke. So he's keeping the metaphor going and invoking it in a nice way. That piece of the promo is outstanding. It's great. It's great. And it shows that Austin Tower has more aspirations than just this match. It's about letting everybody know. Yeah.
Money game can't match the left-hand path. And we're going to show that September 11th.
Wow.
You hear that? Train's coming.
Okay. I was just going to say, the motorcycle thing that happened before sucked. I can see why Eric didn't want to re-record, because sometimes when you hit it, and you hit it right, you don't want to re-record. I would have re-recorded, but that's a minor quibble. But that train, you can't ignore the train. And now I want to see what Austin Towers does improvising based on that train noise.
That September 11th.
Mental switch. That?
Train's coming. It's going to so run far, so down your asses that you're gonna be begging for us to stop, but it's no mercy. Cause we're gonna take this whole damn company and we're gonna drag it, kicking and screaming, down the left hand fucking path.
Come on, man. He even invoked the fucking, he's Charlie fucking Anarchy, they're the left hand fucking path. Come on, man. That's great. That's great. That's great. That's Super Mario great. Oh my God. They just hit the freaking mushroom, the freaking fire flower. They hit all of that on you. Look at that. They're killing motherfuckers with that promo. They're killing motherfuckers with that promo. That's Charlie Anarchy on the ground over there hurt and dying. I mean, this stuff is so good. What a great promo. I want to get this thing up there because it was just that good. Yo, I'm Stephen Platinum, and I am duly impressed.